Hi everyone, and thanks for watching this video. In this short clip, I'm going to talk about how to create a Careers for Monarchs account, how to post a job in Careers for Monarchs, how to clone a job in Careers for Monarchs, how to look at and review your applications, and what to do after you make your student selection. So to get started with creating an account or logging back into your Careers for Monarchs account, you would go to odu.edu/CDS. From there, you would click on Careers for Monarchs. And from there, you would click on ODU Careers for Monarchs Employer Login. And the reason you're actually going to go to the employer login is because the system, as far as it's concerned, you're hiring someone, you're hiring a student, you're an employer. And some people want to click on the advisor because that would better represent who they are. But as far as the system is concerned, you are an employer. So you would click on that to get started. If you're a returning user, meaning you used Careers for Monarchs last year and you just need to get back into the system, you would put in the email account that you utilize to start your profile and everything, and you would put in your password. If you don't remember your password, just select Forgot Your Password. It'll prompt you to put in the email address, and then it'll send a temporary password to your email address that you're using here. That's how you would get that to get started. If you've never used Careers for Monarchs before in the past, or for whatever reason you started the process and you just stopped, you would click on New Employer. And once you click on New Employer, you're going to get prompted to this website, to this page. It looks a little different. It doesn't look ODU-ish, but it is a part of our system. So it's what our Careers for Monarchs is housed in, Purple Briefcase. It starts out pointing you to this $400 yearly account. Don't do that one. You want to do the free version because you don't need to pay for anything with this system. You'll just click on Get Started under the free account option. Once you get there, you're going to put in the company name. And for all ODU departments, to keep everything cohesive and clean, if you could just type ODU dash and then your department name. So for instance, my department is Career Development Services, and I'm just going to put CDS for the time being, but you can put your department's name, and you would fill in all this information as it applies to you. Please don't put your own personal home address or your own personal mobile phone number into the system, because students will be able to see that information when they're applying. If you want to put your cell phone, that's completely up to you, but don't feel like you have to. What I usually recommend is putting your direct office number into the mobile number section. That way, if someone needs to call you directly, they can do that, or you can put your department's phone number there, or you can skip either of these altogether. If it doesn't have a star, you can skip it and you would hit continue. I'm not going to do all this information because you can fill out all that stuff on your own. Click next and everything like that. Once you actually get into the system, it'll look like this. So once you actually get in here, please, please, please make sure that you connect with ODU. A lot of times employers won't actually connect with the university, and then students at ODU won't be able to see your job posting or your opening. So to connect with the school, you would use the school code, which is ODU155. Again, that is ODU155. And then you would put it in this area right here. So, and then that's how you would submit and connect with the school. Okay. Once you connect with the school, then your account will connect with anything that you used to have in CareerLink. So let's say, for instance, you had an account in CareerLink in the past. Everything attached to your email address in CareerLink will be attached to your email address in Careers for Monarchs. So if you go to My Jobs, you'll see expired jobs, and those expired jobs would be your jobs that ported over from CareerLink. If you don't have any expired jobs, we didn't have any jobs to port over from CareerLink or whatever, for whatever reason, and you would need to post and upload your job. To do that, what you would do is go to Add a Job. When you click on Add a Job, you can put in all the information here. You would select Federal Work Study, make sure this says Submit, and it should have all of your information right in here. You put your title, job description, all that good stuff. And make sure you fill out everything, because if you try to go without it, it'll give you these red boxes telling you what you missed. That's how you would post the job. It will take us a day to usually publish the job, depending on when you post. But as soon as you post and I can see it, I'll publish it so that it'll actually be seen by students and different things like that. When you have a job, if you have some expired jobs, what you may find is that you want to clone the job. So let's say I wanted to clone my Federal Work Study Heart of Compassion tutoring job. If I click on Edit, scroll down to the bottom, I have the option to clone it. So the reason you may want to clone this job is this particular job posting has all of my applicants from this year as well as from past years. So if I don't want to look at everyone every year, what I would do is I would clone the job, and then I might, if I hit clone, then I might change the title to Fall 2018. So that job is now a new job that I can post, and I'll get a new set of applicants for. And then once I'm finished with that, I would hit save. And I need to check this, sorry. And then it's submitted. And that's what'll happen when you do any edits. It won't go into published until it's been approved by Career Development Services. And like I said, we usually do that in about a day or so. It just depends on who we have approving jobs that day. It's not automatic, but we go in consistently and are always approving jobs. So just give us a little bit of time. Once you actually post your job and it gets submitted, like we have here, we have two jobs published, you'll be able to go to job applicants. And as you can see, I have a lot of job applicants for the different jobs that I have posted. So what I might want to do is I only want to see the applicants for these two positions. So I would click on whichever position that I actually want to see applicants for. So if I do that, then it pulls up this information for me. And as you see, it went from 167 to 9. And that's kind of how you go from there. Once you get in here, you can use this status section if you would like. That is for your own personal use. I don't look at those or utilize them at all, but you can use this status section to kind of keep things organized while you're reviewing applications. So let's say, for instance, you wanted to check off a few boxes because these are the students who applied this last year. So all these students applied in 2017. I don't really want to review their resume at this point. So I could click on those and click hide, or I can click on those and do declined or anything like that. If you check on boxes, you can hide candidates. You can change their status here. And then if you change their status here, so let's say I didn't want to look at those, and I only wanted to look at the students who are under review. You can go there and you can choose on reviewed, and then only the reviewed students are going to pop up. So you can kind of help organize yourself to see what you need to see and do what you need to do when you're looking at your applicant pools. That's an option within the system. I'm gonna get rid of all of that. And then once you're finished on that end, once you look at your applications, you interview the students who you're interested in interviewing, and you make your selection. The way that you'll officially let me know who you're hiring is through the ODU Supervisor Help Form. So that link is attached to this email, and you would just click on one of these three boxes here. So I've identified a new student to hire, or I would like to rehire a student, or group hiring. Sometimes in the beginning of the semester, you may do group hiring if you're hiring multiple students. So let's say you've been allotted three or four positions. Instead of having to do, I would like to hire or rehire a student, you can just do group hiring. That way you can do all of them in one form at one time. You don't have to just keep doing submitting the same information over and over again. And I'm hoping that that will actually help to clean the process for you so you don't have to go in as many times. But if this you're rehiring student, that means they've worked for you specifically in the past and you're rehiring them. For a new student, that means you've hired a new student, you posted, you have a new student that you want to hire, and then group hiring, we just talked about that. So whichever option you select, you will need the following information. You'll need your position number, you'll need your student's UIN, you'll need their award amount. And the reason that you need that award amount is because students with federal work study, they can only earn up to a certain amount. Sometimes, yes, in the past we have been able to increase their awards, but that's not standard. That's just if the budget allows it, we're able to do it. So you have to know your student's award amount because your student can only earn that much money. Any additional money over that award amount would possibly have to come out of your budget, out of your department's individual budgets. So talk to your students, ask them what their financial aid award is. Based on the hourly rate that you're paying them, that's how many hours they can work. Students really shouldn't work over the number of hours that they can work based on their award amount and your pay rate. Please note that your pay rate does not depend upon the student's award amount. Their pay rate should be dependent upon their work level and their skill level. If you have any questions about any of these processes, you can feel free to give me a call or shoot me an email. You can also email fws@odu.edu. Again, that's fws ws@odu.edu. You can sometimes get a quicker response there as well. Thank you so much for listening. If you have any other questions, just give me a call or shoot me an email. Thanks.